Hey guys, it's Tamara here from Girlfriend Mag, and I'm so excited because we are here with the band Masketta Fall. Hey guys!
Woo! Hello!
So we have Molly, Brayden, Jamie, and Ben. What's up guys? How are you?
Doing good.
Using an ice cream as a microphone?
That's how we roll here at Girlfriend. Okay, so I know you guys have a new album out and your fans have been eagerly awaiting this one. So can you tell us a little bit about it, how it all came together?
Yeah, cool. Golden, our debut album. It's been... Ooh, this is the microphone.
Use the microphone, please, Ben.
Can you guys hear me at home? Beautiful. Great. Our brand new album, yeah, Golden, just came out. It's exciting. It's full of songs that we wrote over the last 2 years. Lots of stories from the band about rejection and love and... all those fun sorts of things.
Heartfelt.
It's really exciting to have it out. The fans are really enjoying it. And we're just on a little launch tour at the moment.
Awesome. Where's that taking you?
So we started off in... Where did we start? We started in Brisbane. And then we went over to Perth. Yep. And then we played in Sydney just the other night, and we're off to Melbourne next week.
Awesome, so exciting. That's where you're from, yeah?
Yes.
Melbourne.
Yep.
Shout out to Melbourne guys out there.
Yeah.
So, last year you guys toured with one of our faves, Ms. Demi Lovato.
Yes.
That's amazing. First of all, congratulations
Thank you.
What was that like? What's she like? Did you guys, like, hang out and eat pizza backstage?
It was good, yeah. She brought us backstage. It was, like, crazy parties and stuff. No. I'll give you the sad, truthful answer. I think she, because she's such a megastar, obviously...
Yeah.
We only really got to see her a couple times on the tour and got a few snaps of her and stuff. But
she
was lovely when we were with her for a little bit. So
I mean, I said hi to her once in the hall and she went, hi, like really nice.
That's good.
Cheerful smile. And it made me think, she's a nice girl.
Yeah.
Just from a hi.
Yeah.
Better than if she just didn't say hi at all. She was just like, no.
Yeah. She acknowledged my existence. It was amazing.
That is amazing.
I had this weird haircut at the time. It was like shaved on the sides, looked like a mane from a horse.
So majestic.
And she, despite the terrible look of it, she said, I really like your haircut.
Oh, well, that's
so.
I feel like that's a lie because no one liked that haircut.
Yeah, I feel like she was definitely lying about that because if I could go back, I'd definitely change it. But maybe she was boosting my
confidence. Nice either way.
Oh, nice little
plug
there. The Demi song. Yeah, that's good. She's like, she paid you guys or something. did she have any pre-show rituals or anything that we should know about? Like hands in the center or anything?
No, I didn't hear her doing vocal warm-ups.
In Melbourne, yeah, she had She closed the doors of her dressing room and brought her whole crew in and had a massive dance party.
Oh,
do you remember that?
Yeah, it was really loud.
Yeah, it was super loud. I'm pretty sure they were playing Taylor Swift or something and they were all screaming and
having
a massive...
And you guys were just outside let us in, we would have danced.
Basically, we were eating dinner at the time and we're like, what's going on in there? Yeah.
Oh, that's super cool. So you're off on an Aussie tour next February promoting the album. I want to know what would be on your dream tour rider? And no request is too out there.
I've always wanted to have a mystery box on the rider to see what they give us.
What does that entail?
It would just be a box with a question mark on it and then we open it up to find a surprise.
What
do you hope it's in there?
I don't know. It's up to them.
Yeah.
I just want to see what people's imaginations are like.
Amazing. What about you?
I would like to have just a baby something. Any kind of animal.
Ooh.
Yeah.
But not a human though, because they're the only babies that aren't cute.
It's a lot of responsibility.
I actually did ask for a goldfish once and they didn't bring us a goldfish.
Oh,
so.
Debo.
I'm not very glamorous. I'm really into sweet and salty popcorn at the moment.
Okay.
Shout out to sweet and salty popcorn. It's awesome. I just would love a little pack of that. It doesn't even need to be a big pack. Just 100 grams.
That's a modest demand there.
I know. I'm sure you could just change that with... You could get that on the rider.
I'm a very simple person. That'll do me really well. Yeah.
Awesome. Low key. Love it. What's the craziest or the coolest thing that a fan has ever done for you guys?
A fan bought me she designed shoes for me.
Oh, wow.
Bought a blank pair of shoes, a white pair. I didn't even know you could buy a white pair of shoes.
Yeah.
And drew on them and drew lyrics and just designed the whole thing with texters, different colored texters.
Do you wear them?
They didn't fit me, but it's a nice thought.
Thanks
for that, girl.
Some fans in Adelaide actually made us a giant collage album of
nice.
Our whole band.
Like a yearbook kind of thing, yeah.
Oh,
literally,
amazing.
Photos of us, doing key things that year, photos with us from shows we played and getting snaps with them. We've still got it, so it's nice to do things like that.
Yeah, that's so cool. I mean, I know your fans obviously love you guys a lot and have supported you all the way through.
Yeah.
So anything that you want to say to your Aussie fans out there?
Oh, definitely. You guys are awesome.
I was about to ask you guys to play a little game with me.
Yep.
And you have to own up to if it's you, the description that I'm going to read out.
Okay.
Point to the person in the band that most identifies with this
cool.
statement.
Cool.
You can
okay?
do it.
All
right.
Are
you
ready for this? Okay, so who is the best prankster in the band?
Probably Jamie.
Yeah.
I like to do the whole stand around the corner and wait for people to walk past, and as they walk past, I yell
and scare
make them jump.
Ooh, yeah.
I get a kick out of it. I get a kick.
Who calls their mum the most?
Brayden again.
Hey.
Yeah.
I love my mummy. Yeah. She's probably watching at the moment. Hi, mum.
His mum's actually awesome. His mum is a pretty good mum.
Oh, does she like make like frozen orange squares for you guys?
She brings us platters of food before our show.
That's cool lemonade.
Every time I visit her, she always like packs like all these esky bags full of food. She's like, here, take that home.
Oh,
we're
so
we're
cool.
not even Italian, mum. Why are you doing this?
That's awesome. Okay, who spends the most time getting ready in the morning? That's a unanimous answer, my friend.
Yeah, I'm an easy target in this band. I don't know why, but I'm just an easy target.
Because you got red hair and no one likes you? No, I'm just kidding. You're right.
That's you mean. Have fabulous hair.
Thanks. It takes me a while to get it ready, and a subtle blow of the wind will ruin it. So
yeah,
I've got to just try and... It's very mushroomy right now, so...
Just got to keep it in check. What's your secret to, you know, the volume? Because I could really use some tips here.
Maybe my great-great-grandma. She just gave it to me.
Didn't she have an afro?
Yeah.
She had one of those granny afros, didn't she?
Granny afros. Do they exist?
Yeah. My grandma's got one.
Okay.
Who eats the dodgiest food in the band? When you guys are like out touring.
Probably Brayden at the moment. He loves like, every time we drive past like a McDonald's or something, he's like, can we get a frozen Coke?
Yeah.
All right,
I can't
do
that.
Yeah, I know, but every time, though, every single time, he loves it.
You know, I feel like that's...
You drink drain water.
Moving right along, who takes the most selfies?
Ben.
What's the secret to the perfect selfie, Ben?
Oh, well, great lighting is number one. Number
Are you
two.
Like natural lighting kind of guy?
As long as it's lighting the face well,
yeah.
That's key. Obviously, you guys probably already know this.
Cloud coverage is good. I can chip in.
Yep.
Cloud
coverage is great.
Coverage
I think
is good
a key light. Thing, another key thing is the angle. You want to make sure it's up a little slightly higher than your eye level because it shoots down and gives you a little better... Bit better definition in the face.
That is a really good tip.
Is that why you also tense your jaw as well?
No, I'm just...
And you squint your eyes a little bit too.
He does, he's
enjoying
it a little.
Can you give us a... right in the camera there?
Right into the camera, right into the camera.
He's going to do it. Live demo. There you go. You saw it here first, guys. Who gets, like, the most attention from the female fans of Masketta?
I'm going to put my hand up.
Yeah, I'd say Molly.
Molly.
Yeah.
It's the luscious hair, I think.
It's my hair's quite wispy as well, but it's luscious, the hat...
Yeah.
And,
is the hat the trademark?
Well, like I used to wear like a funny beanie before this, so I always have a hat, around that.
You've evolved your hat.
Yes.
It's probably also your lashes and your eyes.
I do have nice lashes, very girly
your
lashes.
Perfect nose and your wonderful lips.
Oh, this is a bit cute.
I was going to say his baby tooth adds to the charm as well, the youthful charm.
You got a baby tooth.
Where's that?
Up there.
Disgusting. Oh, my God.
Yeah, it's almost see-through.
I don't even know what to say about that. Who is like the organized one that always cracks?
Benjamin.
Yeah, you're the whip cracker. You get people every on time. Who's like the hot mess who never shows up on time?
Molly.
Molly's known as the hurricane in
the
band.
The hurricane.
His nickname is the hurricane. Yeah.
Just what like why is?
Well, he'll get things done, but in a
very messy fashion.
You'll say this room when you leave. You'll say what we mean.
I just leave things and don't get
over there.
Yeah.
Awesome, guys. Well, we've actually got some fans of you guys to write in and ask some questions. So I'd love if you could answer some of those. So make sure you're checking in to see if your question gets answered. So Annika wants to know, what venue to perform at will make you go like, okay, we've made it now, big time?
First of all, hi, Annika. Thanks for the question.
I would say Horden Pavilion or where do we play in Melbourne? Festival Hall?
Margaret Court Arena.
Festival Hall would be. Festival Hall, so
yeah.
Something like that.
Closer to home, yeah.
We play them already with the Vamps, but if we could do it ourselves, I think it'd be awesome.
Like a headlining.
Yeah, headlining.
Yeah, awesome. I'm sure it won't be long till you guys get there. Chantel wants to know who can pull the best double chin and demonstrate, please.
Yeah, I'd say Brayden.
Nah, Jamie by far.
Wow. We might need to center that one.
That was big.
That was beautiful.
Opto chin.
Mel wants to know, good question, Mel. If you could only listen to one song for the rest of your life, what would it be?
Okay.
Mine would be The Little Spanish Fleet.
Which is
I feel like that would drive me
crazy.
I'm a big fan of the Pokemon theme song, so that'd be mine. Yeah, I've got the whole To Be A Master album on my iPod.
Yeah, I'd probably say Larger Than Life by Backstreet Boys.
Oh.
It's a great song.
Classic. If you haven't heard it, YouTube now, immediately.
I don't even know. Dragon Ball Z? I'm into Dragon Ball Z.
No,
I'm just kidding.
What are you talking about?
Papa Peach wants to know.
Ooh. Oh, that's a sick name.
Papa Peach. Papa Peach. I love it. She like name a single after him or something like that. Him or her, I'm not quite sure. Papa Peach wants to know, what's the last photo you took? What's the last photo you took on your phone?
I just took a selfie just then to show you how to take a selfie. So that's me covered.
That's you.
Mine was actually, somehow some people from our Sydney show got my phone, and there's heaps of like selfies in there. From,
oh,
they just took selfies on it. Luckily they gave it back to me.
That's so good. But how did they acquire your phone?
I have no idea.
Mysterious.
Yeah.
I think mine was just a friend that we ran into the other night when we were,
yeah,
after we played in Sydney. It was just a guy that lives in Sydney now, and I haven't seen him for ages, so I hung out with him.
Boring.
Got a
photo. Boring.
What about you, Jamie?
Mine, I took a photo of Braden just downstairs for his Instagram, but he didn't like it, so.
That's because I was blinking.
And one more one more viewer question. Gemma wants to know, what is your favourite song on the new album?
My personal favourite is Butterflies. I think it's because the writing experience was just really fun. Like, we wrote with a couple of dudes that we became really good friends with.
Mm.
Yeah.
So for me, that's my favorite.
Mine's probably I Believe, which is our single that is out today, the video.
That's actually a really good segue.
Yeah.
Because we are very lucky today because the boys are going to perform for us an acoustic version of their new track, I Believe. So when you're ready, guys, take it away and I will exit stage right or left.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for coming and chatting to
all
us,
good.
Girlfriend.
Pleasure. Thanks for having us.
Enjoy, guys.
I don't need no microphone.
Now she's gone, let's steal this. No, I'm just kidding.
Nice Molly.
This is our new single, I Believe, which has come out today. There's a music video on our Facebook page, so go check it out if you like it.
Don't get away from me.
I'd see her out there every Friday night. Out in the moonlight, her smile so bright. I've always been the one to chase this feeling. Yeah, I believe in love. Her bounty blowing in the summer air. The bluest stars, I get lost in her stare. I've always been the one to chase this feeling. Yeah, I believe in love. You can say that I'm a dreamer. Open ever since I've seen ya. I can't get you out of my head, yeah, yeah. Now I know, I believe in love, I believe in love, I believe, yeah, I believe in love. She moved out, heard that she moved on. How do you stop love that's burned for so long? Someday I know I'm gonna find that feeling, just like when we were young. You're everything that I need, the only one that I see. And when you wrap your arms around me, I still believe in love.
I believe in love.
I believe in love, I believe in love, I believe, yeah, I believe in love.
Whoa, whoa, whoa,
yeah. I believe in love. I'm a dreamer. Oh, but ever since I've seen ya, I can't get you out of my head. Yeah, yeah.
One, two, three, and go.
I believe in love. I believe in love. I believe, yeah, I believe. Yeah, I believe in love.
Creeping it up, I love it. Hope you guys enjoyed hanging out with us today. It's been awesome. Our album here, Golden, is out now, so go check it out everywhere. And the music video for that song you just heard is on our Facebook now, so go check it out.
Also, we're going to be on tour in February and March next year, travelling all the way around the country. Going to be playing basically the whole album in full right there, aren't we?
All right.
So we'd love to see you guys there.